Howdy, folks. I'm John Robert Mallernee here at the Old Soldier's Home. And here's an Irish song that, again, is a true story. And it tells the importance of, or the song rather shows the importance, of doing your genealogy and doing your research and knowing your family's history. Because what happened in this case, this fellow was cleaning out his basement and he came across a bunch of letters in an old trunk. And he read those letters. They were written to his ancestor who had come to America from Ireland. And as a result of reading those letters, he wrote this song. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, is so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to a half of them bad. And your sister Brigid and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has gotten a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, and now we have nothing to burn. Brigid is happy and named a child for her, although she's got six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you'll be coming home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1880, Michael and John, my sons. Sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Brigid were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayer. And it's so good to learn that Michael's returning with money he's sure to buy land. For the crops have been poor and the people are selling at any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, my dear and loving son John. Guess that I must be close on to 80. It's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all of the money you send me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters are grown. Thank you for sending your family picture. They're lovely young women and men. You sigh you might even come for a visit. What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, to my dear brother John. Sorry I waited so long to write and tell you our father passed on. He was living with Brigid. She says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. All You should have seen him play with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of Mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny how he kept talking about you. He called for you at the inn. Why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you again.